Well, good morning. How's everyone doing? Who's here to praise the Lord? How many people have praises this week? How many people have been telling about God's praises this week? Amen? So glad y'all are here. Please be seated. Just a quick reminder, we are still having our Thursday morning prayer. If you are able to be here at 10 o'clock on Thursday mornings to pray, we have some great leaders, Miss Paula and Miss Gracie, is that right? So are helping lead the prayer in the
That's not Paula. That's Grace and Mercy.
Oh my gravy. I was like, did I see her name? Okay. Good morning, y'all. Also, if you, as a reminder, we are taking up funds for our building. So the red bucket is for our building. The gold plate is for our tithes and offering. And next Saturday, May 21st, we have a work day. We will be starting promptly at 9 o'clock. So if you could be here about 8:45 and get your instructions, that would be great.
You better tell them 8 o'clock. If they're like you, they'll be here by 9.
No comments from the peanut gallery. Huh? We got altars just to lay him on. The pastor needs the altar. So anyway, but if y'all could be here about 8:45, Brother Brian will be giving instructions and put everybody in their place so we can get some things accomplished next Saturday.
Oh, my favorite job, put you in your place.
And we'll be doing that till what, about 1?
Until we get through.
Oh, until we get through. So come ready to work so we're not here till midnight, because he will keep us here till midnight. So, right, Zach? So, VBS is coming up. C-Ray Joyce, I know she needs lots of volunteers. And I didn't read your list, but lots of volunteers is the main thing right now, right? And all the goodies, there's a list over there on the bulletin board that you can look at as well for VBS. VBS is July 21st through the 23rd, 6:30 p.m. to 8 o'clock p.m. And then the parent day will be during service on July 24th. So y'all come prepared for that. Also, next Sunday, is that Memorial Day?
No. No,
2 weeks is Memorial Day, and so we'll have our service outside.
Huh? Don't rush it.
Okay. We'll have our service outside. We'll be doing chicken legs and hot dogs and hamburgers, and we'll have our service and just have a good time. As of today will be our, as Brian said, our final supper after church.
I said the last supper.
The last supper. Last supper after church until further notice. There's some changes going on, so y'all be praying for us as we seek wisdom and guidance, and as Brian said this morning, some counsel as we are in a season of change right now with our church. So today, we want y'all to come enjoy the meatloaf and the potatoes that all the ladies are working together to prepare. Okay? Did I forget anything?
Maybe the tithes and offering about how we just bring it up when you're ready. We don't
tithes
have a designated time.
Most of y'all know we just bring it up, bring it into the storehouse, so y'all can just, during music, y'all can bring it, or after service, you can walk by, whichever is easier for you. Father, in the name of Jesus, we just come to you this morning, Lord, and we thank you. Lord, so many times we take advantage of your blessings.
Yes, yes.
And Father, I just pray that we will seek your face this morning as we go into a time of worship. That we will worship you, that we will put aside every thought that hinders us from focusing on you. Lord, as we're in this season of change, we just pray for your wisdom and your knowledge. We thank you for all that you've done. We thank you for what you will do. Lord, take over this service. Bless the music. Let it be a sweet sound on your ear. Bless the speaker, whoever may bring the message, Lord. And we pray it's a message from you, something we need to hear today. And we ask all this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Ooh, glory, glory, glory.
If your blood ain't pumping, I don't do mouth to mouth, so you're just on your own. So get up and get happy. Why are we happy? Because we serve an awesome God. Situations don't dictate how I feel. Oh, I said situations don't dictate how I feel. Man's philosophy doesn't dictate what I believe. Because I believe in a risen Savior who still breaks chains, who still opens prison doors, sets the captive free. Yes, Lord. Oh, yes, He does. Yes, opens prison doors, sets the captives free. I got a river of life flowing out of me. Woo! Well, glory, I tell you what. I'm excited this morning. I'm tarred. Matter of fact, my tar will get here next week. I'm so tarred. But you know what? God is still God. God is still delivering. And no matter what we see has changed, God never has. And He never will. He's the same yesterday, today, and forever. I said He's the same today as He was yesterday. And He'll be the same tomorrow. My job may fail me. My spouse may fail me. My mouse in the house with my spouse may fail me. But my God will never change. Oh, I tell you what, if there's nothing I'm learning right now, and that is how to hold to His nail-scarred hand, to His unchanging nail-scarred hands. Woo! Oh, Lord Jesus. Boy, I got so much going on my head right now. I'd love to be able to sing that song, Hold to God's Unchanging Hand. Oh, man. Woo! Come on, enter into His presence. Bring His glory on down. He said, I will fall when my people accept me. I inhabit the praises. That means I will dwell with them that praise me. Glory, 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 glory. Glory, 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 glory. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, Jesus, Jesus, it don't take music to bring down glory. What it takes is God's people to open their mouth and begin to praise and worship, giving Him glory, making fool of ourselves for Him. Not for ourselves, not bringing glory to us, but unto Him. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory, Sanna Makasana Mabosi. Hallelujah. Oh, they that call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved, shall be delivered. God knows His people are needing some things. He's here to supply. I said He's here to supply. Oh, hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Oh, glory, glory, glory. Aramahana makotoro bosandara masandara. There's a guy, I've told you about him before, he's a plumber. And he comes to me constantly And I try, though I work for a government, I try not to misuse somebody else's time because you're on their clock and they want you to do their job. But he comes in and he has been in the presence of God to the point, revelation after revelation after revelation after revelation is pouring through him. And he's never experienced this before. He was a good old Baptist boy who enjoyed going to church three times a week. And it's nothing against the Baptist. I'm just saying I know him because I went to church with him a few times. Sing a few songs, hear a little short devotional. I wouldn't say it was a message. And get up and go home. He was good with that. He drank, he cursed, he smoked, and the church was good with that. But God wasn't. He divorced his wife, not one of them. He ain't Solomon. He didn't have... Because of indifferences, he married another lady. He come to me the other day and he said, "Brother, I love you because you listen to me. You hear what God is doing. Most pastors run from me." He said, and this is coming from a man who has been broken. "I backed over my 10-year-old daughter and killed her." My heart broke. Then he said, "Now my second wife is leaving. She doesn't understand the God that is beginning to rise up inside of me." And I liked what he said there. He didn't say, "The God who's coming upon me." He said, "The God that's rising up." Because, folks, God is in us. We just need him to rise up. But he cannot rise above what we won't let him rise. God will give us just as much of him as we will let him. We'll take just as much of mama's homemade chocolate pie as we can get, or daddy will allow us to have. Because he done ate it all. God's the same way. If we want more of him, we've got to go get more of him. Not that it's not in us, it's already here. We've just got to develop it, Brother Jim, and let him bring it out. Brother, help me out with a word. The thing that the priest wore in the old days, the shem, what's it called? Somebody help me. The priests, the garment thing that he put around him, not a shim, not a sham. Yes, that's close. Ephod. See, there's a place that we have to get to the point to where the pastor's ephod is not going to work anymore. The priest ephod doesn't need to be. He said, "Well, that's against the rules of God." No, it's not, because David would have been struck dead. David got to a place where he said, "Priest, that's great. I love what you're doing, but I need the ephod because I need to learn from him myself. I need to know what God is
saying myself in the book of Samuel. He said, and the priest surrendered it to David. And David went into the presence of God. And that's Old Testament. In the New Testament, we can do so much more because the veil has been rent in half. And we can go boldly to God and say, Father, I need. And he will say, here you go. Here you go. You need joy, Dougie? You need laughter? Here, let me pour it on you. You don't need 19 gallons of oil poured upon your head. All you need is the presence of a living, loving Father. That is all. You look around and you say, well, these aren't here and those aren't there and they're not there. Hold on, there was a time when we weren't there. But Jesus never said, stop believing. Even a worldly rock band had enough sense to write a song that says, keep believing. Keep on believing. And we as Christians, if we don't get it out of the microwave in 30 seconds, we're through with it. God's just not in it. Just because God didn't answer right then does not mean it's not God's will. Daniel prayed 21 days. And when the angel arrived, he's going to use a better term than I did, but I'm East Texan. He goes, Daniel, you could have stopped as soon as it went through your mind. Because the answer was already on the way before you prayed. But Satan, he said, I met opposition. Anything worth having is worth fighting for. You take my wife away from me and I'm going to burst your chops. You try to pull her, I'm going to pull a gun. You try to take what belongs to me in the spirit, I'm pulling a Holy Ghost shotgun. I'm going to blow holes in the devil and say, you can't have what's mine. The church has let the devil come and take. The Bible says the cankerworm will have to pay back that which he ate. The cankerworm can't eat if you squash that bug. Well, our nation is just in a mess. It's your fault.
That's right. It's the church. It's the church.
Are you not the church?
Right.
I'm not talking to a bunch of unbelievers up in here today. I'm talking to the church. It's our fault that the country is in the shape it's in. Great and prosperous is the country whose Lord is the Lord God. In case you haven't noticed, God is not the Lord of this country. We need to pick up our ephods and we need to get busy in our prayer closets. We need to quit sitting around on the outside and expecting somebody else to do it. Well, that's the preacher's job. No, baby, that's yours. Well, I'm not a preacher. Yes, you are. It says preacher is a messenger of the gospel. The good news of Jesus Christ. In Exodus, the 17th chapter, starting at verse 1, all the congregation of the children of Israel journeyed from the wilderness, and I don't think this is an accident of sin. Baby, if you're in sin, you are in wilderness. You are in darkness. And the truth cannot be revealed, for you have scales on your eyes.
Right.
The plumber who once didn't understand the baptism of the Spirit says, I don't know how I lived without it. He said, why didn't somebody tell me of this sooner? I told him, I said, they did. He said, who? I said, the book of Acts. All you had to do was read it. They told us 2,000 years ago of how great God is and the gifts that God has got for us. Parents, are you conditional with your kids?
Yes.
Aren't we? Honey, if you... I got tickled yesterday. I bought my granddaughter and grandson new fishing poles. I bought them this because they come with that little rubber thing on the end of it. And me and Daddy are glad I did. We had red spots for a while. They got out there, the new place, and they're throwing it. And they're throwing it. And they're learning. I thought this would be a great idea. Because just the week before, or a few days before, what, Thursday, Friday? I don't know where he went. But, oh, there he is. But a granddaughter drew back the cast and whopped Daddy in the head with a pole. With a lure on the end of it. With a hook. No. I wished it was. It might have gotten... No, I'm just kidding. But I ain't wrong. But anyway, I would not want to... Yeah, I would. That'd be fun to get hook out and just... you know, I just... Anyway, I should have been a doctor. Anyway, I am a spiritual one. I wouldn't want him to go through the pain. Don't mistake this. His mother would laugh if he did. You get hurt, she laughs. That's just funny. Bless his heart, he got knocked senseless with a brake caliper. And we walk in, and he's got blood in his hands and running down his face. And she goes, what happened? Dad hit me in the head with a brake caliper. She breaks out laughing. Zach, you're my witness. Right. Had that crimson flow going. He was leaking. Leaking life juice. But that didn't save anybody. But the blood of Jesus that we look through is the only rose-colored glasses we need to be looking through. Anyway, let me get back to my message. The congregation in the wilderness of sin, after their journeys, according to the commandment of the Lord, and pitched a Rephidim, and there was no water for the people to drink. I'm not going to read all of this. I'm just setting the stage so that you understand. The children of Israel are getting thirsty. Are the children of Israel thirsty today? Are you thirsty? Verse 3, and the people thirst there for water. And the people murmured against the pastor.
Yeah. That's right.
And said, wherefore is this that thou hast brought us out of Egypt to kill us? And our children and our cattle with thirst. There's some pretty dry churches around town. I'm just saying, it don't matter what town you're in, there are dry churches. And Moses cried unto the Lord, what shall I do with the people? For they're all
Rome's fixing to stone me.
Amen.
I'm glad that's Old Testament. No, I'm serious. Because they're almost ready to stone me. Have you not seen the stones flying today in the churches on the pastors? Not only from the pastors, but from the congregation.
Amen.
Well, preacher, we just don't like the way you preach, so we're just going to go on to something else. Well, preacher, I saw you in the parking lot smoking meth. I'm going somewhere else. Well, I'll see y'all later. Because I'm that preacher they were talking about. Your friend.
My friend. I don't have any friends like that.
I'm just saying. That's the reason they don't come to church here anymore. Well, guess what? The ones he told, it kept them out of church too. Now, that's a joke. They had something else to do. That's a joke. But I couldn't help but be a Tanya when over the phone I heard so-and-so told us this. And I chuckled. What else can you do? The presence of God does one of two things. When it gets as strong as it has in this house, you will either embrace it or reject it. Then I'll say it again because it's truth. We have to be careful that we don't reject what's God.
Amen.
Reject men, but embrace the God who liveth. I didn't say just God, the one who liveth. We have so many gods in our life. There's two of them hanging on the wall. There's another one in my hand. And every one of you's got another one in your pocket because I hear them go off in church. See, there was a time in history not too long ago. I saw a deal on TikTok. The guy said, my 8-year-old asked me, Dad, what was it like growing up in the Stone Age of the 80s? I was thinking rock and roll. And during the play, it had a picture of a phone with a cord. 100-foot cord, but it had a cord. I mean, we went all through the house, my belly, on a party line. Set it down, wipe the kid's nose, pee. Now, it's so easy. Our kids watch TVs instead of paying attention to what's being taught in church. Our adults are watching what the children are watching because we want to see it, so we let them watch it. We hand them electronic to get them out of our hair. And there's nothing wrong with doing that.
It's the extent that we carry it. I'm not going to say nothing because I ain't preaching against nobody or to anybody. When my kids was little, I knew. Get outside and play. But I would turn on Lion King or The Little Train That Could. We didn't watch Aladdin much, did we? We had our time, but I used that time to teach them that when this time comes, you sit down in church and you sit still and you be quiet. I taught them at church at home so that when we got to church, it was already established. I didn't have to fuss at the kids for something that I didn't do.
Come on.
That's good stuff. Have we learned it? No. Have we began to? Yeah, I hope so. Because mom, dad, grandparents, those children in your congregation. You said, preacher, I wonder where you were going with this. They become your church. And Lord knows my quiver's full. Delbert not only has to put up with me in church, but because he lives with us, he's in my church.
Amen.
What I do affects him, because he's under my roof, and I'm the priest of my home. And I spent 40, how old am I? A few steps years old. So I spent about, up until about, when I married Tommy, I know a few years ago. So that's when I learned how important it is to be the priest of your home and do not waver.
Yes.
Tanya brought such a good word last Sunday for you women. Mothers. Say that. Your mothers. She did. I was very proud. I'm still proud. And I'm not going to cry. I'm not going to promise that, but I'm not going to cry. Because she is a product of this ministry. If Ruby was here, rejoice probably in Mr. but Robert, Sheila, Tanya on this platform stood here like a plank. The only thing that would move is maybe her eye and her mouth so she could sing. I told her one day, I said, honey, I've seen tuba 12s less stiff than that. She goes, well, this is what I was taught. This is how they brought me up through the ministry that I was trained under. You didn't do this. You didn't do that. You didn't, because all of this stuff brought attention to you. No, if you're doing it under the Spirit, it brings attention to the God who saves. It will draw the lost into who you are. It will draw the lost into the God who we boast you. And do you realize, Ian, what is today? About 6 years. Oh, wow. You're taking medicine. It's 12 o'clock. She has gone from being a 12 by 12. That's a post, in case you didn't know. It's a big post. It's stiff, and it don't bend. To weeping. To raising her hands. I've seen her fall on her knees up here. Speaking the word of God from her mouth. Not at home, but in the pulpit. She has gone from saying, kids, you need to do this, to kids, see how I'm doing this.
Yeah.
She's gone from doing, do as I say, not as I do, because I've been there, to look at this. This is how you do it. And it's not an 80s rock song. This is how we do it. It's a brand new dance now, and it's called the Holy Spirit. It's called the Holy Ghost and fire, and it's keeping me alive. Yeah.
That's where she's at. And I'm telling you, that's a product because her and I decided to line up with the Word of God. We perfect? Yeah, you are. We're just as perfect as you are. We make mistake. Matter of fact, when they asked me to be the full-time pastor, I said, well, okay, let me tell you, let me give you my list of expectations and you can see if you approve or not. And Brother John looked at me kind of, okay. I said, if you're looking for a pastor who stumbles, who fails, gets his word tied up, gets his family in a mess sometimes, who can't find his rear end with both hands and a flashlight, who does his wife wrong from time to time, who screams, loses his temper, loses his, well, I can't lose my mind. I never had it to lose. And about two or three other things, and they looked at me, and I thought, well, we're out of here for sure. They said, you're the man we want because... Repentance means to turn. Look the other way. Turn the other way. That's what it means. It says to do a 180 and begin to walk away from it. Never said it wouldn't pursue you, but if you are walking away, it will not catch you. Heard a sermon one time years ago, Brother McNeely. Spiritual Christians don't park and they don't have a neutral. They have a drive, and he said, we're going to change the R for racing. And he said the D is not for defense, because if we're in the driver's seat, we're in the offense.
Yeah.
Now let me get to my point. Oh, hallelujah. Verse 8, then Amalek and fought with the Israelite. Anybody got any Amalekites in their life? Yes. Yes, we all do. We do. And Moses said unto Joshua, choose us out men. Choose us out men. Men, if you don't step up, God will use a woman. Then women can be used in church. Because men won't do their job. Somebody's got to do your job. These men are too busy getting women pregnant and walking away from the responsibility. Shame on you. Preacher done gone to meddling now, hadn't he? The Bible says we have a responsibility. And I'm going to show you. You want to know what's going on up in this house? They're fixing to tell you right here. I'm fixing to tell you. Did I tell you I'm fixing to tell you? You want me to tell you how to keep a full church in suspense? I'll tell you next Sunday. And Moses said unto Joshua, choose out men and go fight. Well, women don't have a place in ministry. I'm going to tell you something. I dare you to get in a spiritual warfare fight with my mother. I used to call her mother my battle axe. Because it was her axe I wanted in the battle. Because I knew when she went to praying, she went to swinging. Prayer was the axe handle. And I knew that when it began to swing, there was victory coming around the corner. Because she was fixing to chop the legs right out from under the enemy. We've got a powerful ministry of prayer here. And it does go around the clock, whether if you realize it or not. It may not be in this house. It may not be in that house. It may not be in that house. But it's going on in a house of a member in this church somewhere. And we are seeing, we are seeing people changed and lives rearranged. We're seeing people coming into the church and we're seeing people going out.
Come on. That's all right.
Sometimes, though, Satan just won't give up and people just won't change. So what do? Father, change them or get them out. Never heard a preacher talk like that. There's something wrong with that man. Yes, there is. Because if you ain't for us, if you ain't for God, if you're not for God, you're also against us. Because we be for God. And we're going to pray for you. But I just stood here 2 weeks ago today. I think you were here. You were right here on the front. And I pray, God, reveal what's going on in secret. Flowers started blooming, Brother Jim. And it was in areas that I wasn't even talking about. But see, when you go to God and you say, God, do what your word says. He don't just do one. He does it right. Completely and wholly. Some of us are praying for crop failure. Tomorrow I will stand on top of the hill. Moses is the old man.
Yes, he is.
He said, I will stand on top of the hill with the rod of God. We have the rod of God. We just need to get it out of the sheath and get it in our hand. We need to get it off the coffee table. Blow some of that dust off of it. Begin to... Take the... in my hand. The pastor told the leaders to do something here. Thank you, brother. Thank you, brother. And they did it.
Yes.
According to how he said.
Yes.
Amen.
When God reveals something in a specific manner, that's exactly how he expects it to be performed. You put a car together. Matter of fact, it said, let us assemble. Now I ain't going to take that off so I don't lose it. That pen assembled?
No.
Is that a pen? Are you sure it's all there? What happens if I put this in backwards? But it'll be together.
I hope I got that in backwards that time. I don't know. I didn't have my glasses on. I can't see it. No, I got it in right, didn't I? Yeah, I did. Darn it. Dad, burn it! There we go. Well, Sam Peck. There we go. I got it now. I got it now. Guess what? When the pieces are not in place, it will not go together. But when the master... You need to sit on that in a minute. But when the master takes it in the hand, when the creator thereof takes it in his hand and begins to assemble it. Watch it. I probably got it upside down again. Not trying to. Got it right. See how easy that goes together? I mean so easy. Clips in my pocket. Pocket won't work right. Clips in my pocket. The ink doesn't get on the material. You can pull it out. But baby, when you hit the trigger. When we pull the trigger and it is assembled like it's supposed to be, then the anointing flows so smooth, so easy. It just moves around in the hand of the Creator, and it will make anything on the piece of paper that you want it to be. Because the Master, the Creator, has put His plan into action. When we get assembled, when the church becomes the church and not just a social gathering, when we begin to come up in here for warfare and not play fair. God don't play fair. He plays justly. Well, that's not fair. God never said I'd be fair. He said I'd be just. What's not fair is the way we treat God. I gotta finish. When the old men get up on the hill, the hill symbolizes two things. Calvary, where the blood shed. For the remission of sin, to wipe away our slate. We used to know what a slate was. You had to dig chalk material out of the ground and make a slate with it, make it smooth, and then you could write on it with another material from the ground. One man made. We need to get back to an organic church. Oh, you didn't see that one coming, did you? When the old men get up on the hill, the second thing they can see. Gray hair and no hair didn't come from not learning anything. Most of it because we got ourselves in everything and pulled it all out. Can I get a witness in the house? The rest of it, our children made it fall out. No. Not at all. No. Folks, I'm going to tell you what. Your children do exactly what you allow them to get by with. If you don't teach them at home, they're going to show it in public.
Well, I don't take my children out because they don't act right. Make them act right at home. Bust their butts. Well, we can't do that today. The Bible says, spare the rod, and you've ruined the child. Lord knows, I've been whopped a few times where the good Lord split me, and it didn't hurt me.
Come on.
Well, the proof is standing before you today.
Come on. Yeah. Amen.
I didn't say I didn't stray. When I got old enough to quit being whipped. No, I'm not even going to go there. That's next week. And Moses and Aaron and her went up, and her, not her as in rejoice, her, went up to the top of the hill. And it came to pass when Moses held up his hand, Israel prevailed. When the pastor holds up his hands. And nowadays we're talking about in the spirit. When the pastor holds up his hands, it shows a sign of surrender. It shows a sign of authority. It also shows a sign of God. It's not my battle. It belongs to you. When they get their hands up, when they, that means they're not working by themselves. He had Aaron and her with him. Pastors left to themselves will fail. And it came to pass, and when he let down his hands, the devil won. No, that's not what it says. It says prevailed. Notice prevailed is not an ending. Win or lose is an ending. But Moses was heavy. And they took a stone and they put it under him. They let the man sit down because he was old.
Yes, amen. Come on.
And he sat there on, and Aaron and Hur stayed up his hands. When you can't hold yourself, you got to have somebody to lean on.
Yeah.
Lean on me. When you're not strong, and I'll be your friend. I don't need you as my friend when I can't hold myself up. I need you as a crutch. I need you as a representation of Christ. I need you there to do battle and fight a spiritual warfare for me. I don't need a friend. I need a warrior.
Yeah.
I need a warrior standing beside me. And Aaron and Hur stayed his hands up. The one on the one side and the other on the other side. And his hands were steady until the going down of the sun. That's a long time. And you grab because we're in church more than 15 minutes. He had to worship Brother Randy for hours. With his hands up. And when he couldn't do it no more, the youngsters come up and held him up.
Yes, amen.
When my son can't hold himself up no more, daddy goes and gets him. Holds him up. Lets him lean on him. And the young men, I'm not gonna go any further. I'm gonna hold it right there. And the young men were down in the valley doing the fighting. The point that I'm getting is the old men have done their fighting. They've been their training. They have done their time. They're overseeing everything. And the young men, not talking about age necessarily, talking about in spirit or in rebirth, are now having to tote the flame. George Jones said, who's going to fill their shoes? I ask you to look around you. Who's going to fill your shoes? Who's going to be the next apostle?
who's going to be the next evangelist, the next prophet, pastor, teacher? Who's going to fill their shoes? Mama and Gracie and Leon and Brother Jim and Brother Leah, Delbert, they've got less days in front of them than they did behind them. Brother Dougie, who's now 110, has less days in front than behind. What are you saying? I'm saying is their time is going to come to an end. Who have we raised up to fill their shoes when they're gone? Sister Rosalind walked out of here 2 weeks ago saying, well, if you don't preach Mother Day, I ain't coming. Well, I'll never not preach again. Because she just flat Tuesday morning got up and went to heaven. Died in her sleep. Who's going to fill her shoes? Are we going to sit here and let the church completely die away? No, there'll be a remnant of those who will come out of Zion. Folks, we got to get assembled. Well, I want to stand on the mountain in your time. In your time. See, I'm too old to fight, but I'm too young to stand on the mountain. So I just got one foot in the grave and one on a banana peel. I fight when I can, and I watch when I can. As the pastor, I oversee as best as I can. And then I have to get down off the mountain and do your fighting. Because we're not, and I'm not talking about in a church, just this. I'm talking about in the body, period. The pastors have to get down and fight for the congregation. Because the congregation won't do it. Can't say amen, say oh me. We need to train. And you don't like the message? It's Tanya's fault. It is. And I'm going off her heels. It's not just the mothers. Mothers, and I was trying to say this for Father's Day, but it's not going to happen. If you want the mothers to train up their children, then fathers, do your job. Do your job. Men, do your job. There's so many times I'm guilty that we get our priorities mixed up and out of order, and we spend the money that we had set aside for something on something else. God's not like that. God says, spend your money on what you're supposed to. I'll take care of the rest. That's what a father does. In the book of Hezekiah, God talks about putting our tithes, and I'm not just talking about money here. We're putting our possessions in a bucket with holes in it. What he's saying is we're getting our priorities wrong. And I got news for you. If you're not doing it for God, God's not going to take it away from you, but he'll sure let the enemy come in and take what he stole. He will. So, and I have found out that if I don't give God his part, which is only 10, most of the time the enemy takes anywhere from 20 to 30. I said at least.
Stand with me this morning. Afternoon, whatever you want to call it. I want to issue a challenge to the church today. The church has needs that people don't even know about. And the pastor has to miss some this week because of the job he has to work. And I'm not asking you to pay me to the point that I don't have to work. I'm not asking you to pay my bills or do any of that right there. If we was in the Old Testament, God would be cursed in this church because it's out of order. If we would go back to the ways, there would only be one church in a town. Real church. And they would line up according to. Oh, man. Oh. Woo. Wrong song to play this morning, but it's right on cue. You're going to see me go into worship mode. Woo. What I'm saying is, every one of us has an ability to do something for the Lord, for the kingdom. We need to do what we can for the kingdom, for the church that you attend, that serves you. Do something for it. Don't wait on letting somebody else. Well, that's not my job. If you didn't patch the hole in the sheetrock, put the nails in that are falling out, sweep and mop the floor. Some of you don't know what that means. I'm sorry, I shouldn't have said that. I didn't mean that personally. That's not what I'm getting at. It was a joke. Calm down. If we don't service the car, it'll fall down around us. If we don't put a roof on the house, we won't have a dry place to sleep. This is God's house. I said, this is God's house.
Yes, it is.
This is your place of worship. This place, when people drive by, is a representation of who you are. Not spiritually, physically.
That's right.
They get the spiritual part when they see you, but when they drive by, the spirit will either draw and the curb appeal will push away, or vice versa. I've seen the most beautiful buildings and not have a spirit one in it. Well, not the right one. Let me rephrase that. If the trash is there, pick it up. There have been people pulling nails because we couldn't get anybody to do it for years. Well, a year. Some of us just don't have time. Tanya and I are in this house project, and I'm learning exactly what God said about either you do it or you pay somebody to. You either make time or it comes out of your pocket.
Right.
Well, I don't have any money. No, but you've got great talents. Well, the pastor can fix this. No kidding. I sat here about a month or two ago, and I heard somebody say, man, why don't somebody tighten the screws up on this doorknob over here? And the first thing that went through my head, and I almost come out my mouth, and Tanya said, verbiage, don't you do it. I said, well, you can operate a screwdriver. You see what it fits. Why don't you do it? Now, I'm going to take this to my point this morning. We come to church with hurting people all around us, and we say, why don't somebody pray for them?
Right.
I don't know. Why don't you?
Right.
Why don't you? Why do we sit back and allow the enemy to take and not step in? The Word of God says, you who are spiritual, oh, that's right, we must not be spiritual.
That's what I thought. You who are spiritual, restore such a one. Bear ye one another's burdens. I had a person tell me 2 weeks ago, I left the church because I didn't want to hinder what was going on. And I looked at them and I said, why don't you tell the truth? They said, my flesh was out of line. And I said, then why don't we come to an altar? Because my flesh is out of line. I need to get, you cannot get right before you come to God. You come to God to get right. So folks, let's go get them. I want to challenge you. Hold up the old man's hands. You know, help me. Help me, not just here, but all the ministers who are trying to do it correctly, according to the word. Help them. Hold them. How do we hold up the arm in prayer? Stay out of Brahms a little more often. Either that or invite me to go with you, right? I feel the Lord in that ice cream. I feel the Lord in that. Buy one less Dr. Pepper. Put it in an offering plate. Spend a little more time on the knees. Go into what this song is talking about, the throne room. I see glory as I run inside. And like the plumber friend, when we get into the presence of God, we can walk it day after day after day after day. We just got to get a made up mind to say, I'm not giving up on God. I'm staying in the Word. I'm staying in my prayer. And I'm staying away from those who draw me empty. I will get around those that will fill me up. He said, Brian, every time I get around you, you don't try to empty me. You try to encourage and fill me up. And I looked at him and I said, Brother Doug, God is filling you up so fast it's filling up in me.
Amen.
Because to see what he was, to see where he's at now, just blesses my socks off. I wish the church would get to that point to where we don't. I'll tell you what, we're going to do it right now. I know you've been standing a long time. We're standing on a mountain. Envision with me. We're standing on a mountain. Some of us are in the battlefield. Some of us are on the mountain holding up hands. What are we going to do? We're going to begin right now to start praying all across this building. We're going to start using our tongue, our native language. What's my native language? I'm from America. No, you're not. You're born again. You're a citizen of heaven. You no longer speak English as a native language. Heaven's language is your native language. And we're going to begin to intercede for this church and for this place and for God to bring in that which he needs here. Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we praise you. We give you glory. We honor you. We lift up your name. Can't pray in tongues. See, the Spirit is subject to the prophet. That's you. You have to allow the Spirit to move in through you. You open your mouth. David said, I encourage myself in the Lord and no one around me. What do you do? Encourage yourself this morning in the speaking of tongues, the lifting of hands. Your mind may have one thing, but your spirit may be interceding for someone who is not here, who needed to hear this, who is needing warfare, who is needing their soul grasped out of the clefts of the Satan, of the enemy, to be brought in. Maybe there's been a veil, scales put over their eyes that they can't see. The Spirit knows what to pray.
Hallelujah. 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 Glory, glory, glory. Glory, glory, glory. Sandala boho sikaro sandabasai. Oh, hallelujah. See, when we do this, worry will fall off. All the cares that we don't think can be handled falls off. The waves that we see sloshing around our boat, tossing us to and fro, our eyes get off of it and onto the master, onto the maker of the wind, onto the master of the wind, onto the creator of all things. Shikarabasanaba. Our problems shrink and our God increases. Shiro Sanda Mahatara Kisito. Yindara Mahasara Bakai. Yondara Mahanda Sata Kihi. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Oh, God, we love you. Hallelujah. 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 Soraba Sikamana Maka. Oh, hallelujah. Mm. Andara mahiki soto toro bo yandro mahoshi karya basatoro hosiki yitoro mahosanda mahatara le yaso. Ura bahakara ramo kuriya sikanon hosatara ba. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, Lord. In the throne room, I see glory. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Mm. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, Lord. Mm. Mm. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Mm. Mm. If you need prayer this morning, just come up, stand up on the front. I'll anoint you with oil, and I'm expecting the hand of God to move. You need a touch in your body. Oh, hallelujah. 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 We're not going to use catches. We're not going to use anything. We're not going to use long-term speech. We're just going to say, God, in the name of Jesus, done. Done. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. It's done. Done. Revealed. Refresh. Revealed. In the name of Jesus. From the bottom of his feet to the top of his head. Stir him up. Stir him up, God. Touch him, Lord. Touch him, Lord. Hallelujah. Touch him, Lord. Touch him. Shidorabo kandaramaha. Sandiriya sotarabo kandamahai. Yidorabo sandaramakara sai. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The blood has been applied. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. Jesus. They're going through, but it's going to come to pass and it's going to be done. In the name of Jesus, I've heard your request and I will fulfill that which you have asked. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Who's next? Anybody else? Ora ma sanda na ma kito ro mo shira handa ma kai. Yito ro mo sara ma hai. Yanda ma kai. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. In the name of Jesus, Father. Woo, promotion. I see promotion coming. I'm hearing promotion. God said you're going to a new level. It doesn't mean a new devil, but it does mean a different fight, and it does mean you are equipped for that fight, and you shall prevail, and the gates of hell will not take it from you. In the name of Jesus, hallelujah, hallelujah, healing. Healing's coming. Healing coming. Healing's coming. Healing's coming. Healing's coming. Healing's coming. Hallelujah. 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 Who's next? Anybody? Anybody? Now, this is 2 weeks God has really been pouring out. Don't miss it. Don't miss it. Don't miss it. Don't miss it. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Father, in the name of Jesus. The joy of laughter will fill your house. The joy of laughter. I gave you the gift of laughter. And it is your strength. And it is contagious. And you need to spread it throughout those that you come in contact with. Holy Ghost laughter is not something to contain. You will explode if you don't let it fall out. You don't let it flow. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Father, you know, in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Whoa.
Thank you, Jesus. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Lord, for your blessing.
Oh, my, 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 my. Oh, my. Oh, my. Oh, my. Mama. Tanya. Come here, baby. Come here. Come here. You know what's fixing to happen, baby? You don't know? What do you want to happen?
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
You don't know?
Thank you, Jesus.
You want Jesus to wipe away all that bad dreams and stuff?
Thank you, Jesus.
Do you?
Thank you.
You want him to give you a normal life?
Thank you, Jesus. Thank
God can do it. You know it? Through
thank
the blood of Jesus, through
thank
the stripes
you,
that he wore.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
You know that?
Thank you,
Jesus. Do you believe in Jesus? Did he save you? He washed you in his red blood? You know, you're no longer black with sin. In his eyes, you were white as snow, baby girl. In a flake of a snow, there's a dirt speck right in the center that makes the snowflake stick, has to stick to something. But when the blood of Jesus, there's no dirt speck in the snowflake. You're snowflake. You know that? I'm going to start calling you snowflake. He just changed your name. He did. My wife went through some things. You don't have to, baby. What has been done? He's going to put a hedge of protection around you because you are his child. You may be born from somebody else, but you, baby girl, are a king's kid. Jesus is a king, and you're his child. Father, in the name of Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you.
Devil, you're going to have to move. I can't see through you. Get out of the way. Get out of the way. Let it be revealed. Let it be revealed in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Spirit, no, no, uh-uh. Now, we're not doing this. No, no. You got to go. You've got to clean up her eyes, the memory of her eyes. You've got to clean up the things of her past. Oh, 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 no, uh-uh. Now, now that was wrong. We're not going there. Oh, that was dirty and nasty. No way. Uh-uh. No, let me tell you something, Satan. You may have them, but you don't have her. She is in a Christian home. She's in a God-fearing home. She's no longer in the enemy's camp. She has been taken from Moab into the land of the promises. The promises of which are set forth by God over little children. He said, suffer the little children to come unto me. And forbid them not, for such is the kingdom of heaven. Satan, you cannot have the children. You cannot have this child. You cannot have the brothers. You cannot have the mothers, the sisters, anyone, the father. The father, I will pray, oh, I rebuke that demon off of that father right now in the name of Jesus. Satan, you cannot, demon, you must come forth. I call you forth in the name of Jesus. No longer shall they be possession. You cannot possess that which God has called his temple. I use this little girl as a point of contact. Satan, you're out. You are out. You are out in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Oh, you demon of meth, you demon of pornography, you demon of molestation, you've got to come forth in the name of Jesus and be cast into the sea. I don't care if you go into a bunch of swine, but you do not have the place in this house in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Oh, hallelujah. 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 Embrace it. Embrace it. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Church, you better get ready, because the demon possessed are fixing to start walking through these doors, and it's going to be our responsibility to cast out Satan. It's our job to cast out the demon possession of people. Oh, hallelujah. 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 Glory, 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 glory. Hallelujah. 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 Glory be to the Lamb. Glory be to Jesus. Glory, 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 glory. Not to the angels that are subject, but to the King. To the King of kings and to the Lord of lords be all glory and dominion forever and ever. Amen. Amen and amen. Amen and amen. Hallelujah. 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 Church, I hear the Spirit of the Lord saying, if we will but press and press and keep pressing and keep pressing and keep pressing, those things which we desire of our family and of our church, we will see revival come to this house, to the place of overflowing. This building will be too small. This place will be too small, for the anointing of the revival will be too great for even those to enter in. The revival of Brownsville, I couldn't think, Pensacola. The revival of Pensacola was great. It was great. But you are now in last days, and out in the last days will be perilous times. But in the last days, I will pour out of my Spirit, and it shall be greater than the former, and it shall have double of the original. Oh, hallelujah! 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 But notice he said, if we will continue to seek, continue to press, do not give up. God gave doctors for a reason. But he said, Sister Michelle, he gave you a word this morning, and I'm fixing to deliver it to you. I got the final say-so. God said he, not me, not me. But God said, I got the final say-so. Man may say this, man may say that, but man is what puts you in the place that you're at. And God said, I'm the deliverer from Egypt, and they shall come out into the promised land. I got to say, hallelujah, 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 glory to the Lamb. Woo, now that it's 9 o'clock at night, are we ready to eat? Hallelujah. Food's overrated. Food is overrated. Man shall not live but bread alone, but every word that proceedeth out of the mouth of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to the Lamb. Glory to the Lamb. Father, we ask that you bless the food over in the fellowship hall. Bless our coming in and going out and our fellowship. Oh, Lord. Oh, Lord. Oh, Lord. Hallelujah. Can we dismiss, please? Hallelujah. 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 I still feel like this God is trying to do something, but somebody's resisting.
Pastor will have just ask you to recognize that I am your God, have always been your God. I gave my son for you so that you would have all things, the spirit as well as in the natural. I encourage you today to sell out to me totally in every way. Give myself unto you, say the Lord.
Hallelujah. I receive it. I receive it. Church, it's time to get our priorities in order. It's time to get heaven on our mind. We know we're on our way to heaven. And we know the journey gets sweeter every day. But it's time to get our life in heaven. Set your mind on things that are above. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you for today. We thank you for this service. We thank you for this meal. We thank you for the miracles that we heard go forth. We're just waiting. We want to see the manifestation in this house, but we don't care. We'll take it. They'll go to church somewhere. We don't care, but we want to see it here. But Father, all we know is we did what you requested to the best of our ability. But God, help our ability to be your best. And we give you the glory and the praise in Jesus' mighty name. Amen, amen, amen. Amen. Oh, hallelujah. You're dismissed.